sign outside Jersey, and they're probably going to go, where's that sign gone? It said, welcome, for any assistance, please dial 0. I wasn't really sure how to, they're going to be like, where is that? I saw this and I thought, that's really interesting because I'm going to talk to you about something today that I've not really talked about in, like, I talk about it a lot on video. I do a lot of workshops online. I talked about technology and being disconnected. I totally forget that, what you said this morning. But I thought that was really interesting because I saw that. I thought, how do I start? Talking in front of an audience of people, it doesn't matter how many times you do it. For me, the first bit's always a little bit nervous because there's always the brains kind of going, I hope they like me, I hope they accept me, I hope they validate me. And today is really about you validating yourself, which is why I wanted to start with a magic moment. And which is why I saw that sign and thought the fact that it said, for any assistance, please dial 0. But I said to Elaine, I said, a few minutes ago, wouldn't it be good if you could dial a phone and at the other end was exactly what you wanted to hear and needed to hear at any given moment? Like maybe you've had a shit day and you're just like, I just need to dial 0. And you could just dial 0 and there would be a person at the other end of the phone that would tell you everything that you need to hear in that moment to just make you feel instantly better about yourself.
Thank you for the idea and develop this idea.
Maybe we should. Get to Silicon Valley and do it. A few years ago, I had a session with a coach of mine, and I love to be coached. Has anybody here been coached? There's a difference between being a coach and being coached. And I was coached by my coach, who we were having a conversation, and he asked me. He said, "What are you proud of?" And I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Well, what are you proud of? Like, what are you proud of that you've achieved, say, in the last 3 months?" And I said, "I don't really know. I can't really think of anything that really stands out as that I'm really proud of." And he stopped me and he started to reel off external events because he knows me on a really personal level that I had, in his mind, achieved over that period of 90 days. And he said, how is it that I was able to tell you what you've achieved from the outside looking in like that, but you were not able to come up with those things as quickly or at all the way I did? And I was like, shit, why are my achievements so obvious to the outside world, but they're not obvious to me? And so since that day, that was about 2.5 years ago, and he challenged me and said, I'd like for you to, if you're willing to play, he said, I'd like for you to tomorrow start for the next 7 days. I think it was actually said he started today, as soon as we get off the phone, I think. So I'd like for you to write down every day what you're proud of. He said, but with no specific time frame on it. No, it doesn't have to be 90 days. It could be like your whole life, if you like. Just write what comes up. He said, I'd like for you to write down what you're proud of. And I realized, in that moment, I realized why I've not done that. And it was because there's this little voice in my head that's been running. Me and Ben were talking. It's going to sound weird. We were talking in the toilets. Just to clarify, we washed our hands. And we were exiting the toilets.
I was half naked.
We're getting dressed for this event.
To make it explicitly clear,
we're both in loving relationships with females. Not that I needed to write a female, but anyway, I digress. So it was evidently clear to me that the reason why I've not been kind of writing down or even just why it wasn't so obvious to me what I was proud of was because this little voice in my head had been running this old tape ever since I was little, which said, I'm not good enough. Anybody heard that voice in their head before? I'm not good enough. And I realized why that, thank you. I realized why that tape had been running, because I grew up not too far from here, literally a mile up the road with my beautiful mum, single mum, big respect to single mums. my dad made the decision that he didn't want to be in my life from when I was born. And I realized that from a very young age, I never really fully dealt with that. I never really fully dealt with being what I felt was some form of rejection. You know, why did he not want me? And I've never really dealt with that. But that was a great lesson for me, that coaching conversation. Because what it made me realize was internal validation, like actually validating your own worth, is so important. Like, it's great to have goals, it's great to have dreams, it's great to have ambitions, but at the same time, it's really important to, it's the saying, like, stop and smell the roses. You know, you hear people talk about it, you know, it's the journey, not the destination. It's a great cliche that gets overused. It gets overused because it makes a lot of sense, right? But I know far too many people, I'm including myself in this, who get so caught up in, like, I'll be happy when, like, when I've got that, I'm good. Like, when I've got that thing, when I've got that job, when I've got that girl, when I've been on that adventure, I'll be happy. About 8 years ago, I went volunteering in Honduras. So has anybody ever been to Honduras? Now, I kind of went there because I knew that no one had been there. I've just got this weird thing about going to places people haven't been, right? It's a significance thing, and we'll come to that in a second. I went to Honduras volunteering. I was working with kids in a school who apparently had nothing. They did have a lot of love, but they had nothing in terms of infrastructure compared to what we have here. And I spent 8 weeks volunteering with kids in a school in Honduras. Sounds amazing. It's fucking miserable. On New Year's Eve in Honduras, I was at the coast, the Bay Islands. They're two beautiful islands in Honduras. The beach, the sand is like that color. Beautiful. I was miserable. The reason why I was miserable is because I was kind of like, I'll be happy when. But I was now in Honduras volunteering with kids and I'm still not happy. What's that about? When I look back on that on reflection and I map it forward to that coaching call, that was a real defining moment for me. It made me realize that there were so many things that I could be proud of, but I never stopped to take the time to acknowledge myself for them. Never stopped to take the time to acknowledge the great things I've done. And by that, I don't just mean the external things, I mean like the character development. Like, I think now, and I'll just give you some kind of context, but I think about my beautiful wife who I'm now married to, who unfortunately just, you know, on Tuesday was in hospital because she's at the end of what's been a miscarriage, which has been a really sad period for us, and I'm not going to stand up here and pretend that it's not. But when I think about how grateful I am for who she is as a person, like if she came in the room, most people say that we look alike. We don't. We're not like related just in that way. But the reason why they say we look alike is because we have a similar energy. Like when my wife Sati comes in the room, she's very smiley and very enthusiastic and just has so much love about her. And had I not been through the relationships that didn't work, where I was not the right person for them and they weren't the right person for me, and learned all those things about myself, all those character traits about me that I wasn't, that weren't good. But also, if looking back on reflection, I think, you know, had it not been for those experiences, I wouldn't have met my wife. I wouldn't, being the person I am now, I wouldn't have met my wife. Had I not been through the growth that I've been through, I wouldn't have been with my wife. I know looking back, that the me that stands before you now wouldn't have been ready for my wife 4 or 5 years ago. This session with you today, I really want to highlight that. So my mum ran a gym for 20 years, and motivational speaker Les Brown, have you heard of Les Brown?
Yes.
Les Brown would say, I'm trying to think, you got me hungry! He's like, people say, describe Les Brown, and I'm like, it's like if Barry White was a motivational speaker. That's Les Brown, if you don't know. So now if you don't know who Les Brown is, you're now like, Les, the Les. So anyway, Les Brown also said a great sentence, which I absolutely love. He says, common sense is not always common practice. So my mum ran a gym for 20 years, and would you agree, with a resounding yes, Miles would be great to check he's still alive and well, would you agree that 98%, maybe even higher, of the population of the world knows what to do to get their ideal health and body, but yet they don't have it? The reason why is because common sense isn't always common practice. It's common sense to eat more healthy foods than you eat junk foods, but it isn't necessarily common practice for most people. Thinking about what you're proud about your own life is common sense. That makes sense. I should think about what I'm proud of. Or something that probably is more common today, I believe, than it's ever been, which is gratitude. Of being grateful for what you have already in your life. And even that, to a lot of people, is common sense, but not common practice, to just sit and think about what you're grateful for. But today I want to talk to you about something different. Today I want you, and this is a great friend of mine who's a great speaker, would always say, he'd say, Miles, remember when you're speaking, it's not about you, it's about them. And so in the spirit of that, what I would like to do is I'd like to do an exercise. And in this exercise, what I'm going to do is I've got some cards, because I basically carry these cards around in my pocket every single day. And on these cards, I've got three things. I've got over the last 90 days, the things that I'm most proud about. I've got over my lifetime, things I'm proud about. And then some life lessons. And specifically the life lessons, because then, obviously telling his story at the start of the session, there was parts of that that I'd heard, but there's parts of that I didn't know. And I think life lessons is a really interesting one, because how many of you here would say you've had a life lesson, which was probably, you wouldn't word it a life lesson, you'd say it was a really shit time, tough experience, big fuck up, insert your own swear word. But actually, if it's not raw and in this moment, and it was maybe it's been and gone, and you've emotionally been able to release some of the negative emotions that came with it, you can now look back on it and go, that was a really, really good lesson. Like maybe it was like a painful breakup that at the time was absolutely traumatic and awful, but you can look back on it now and go, I see the lessons from that. So like, for me, I've already said, you know, gave an example, but life lessons, an example for me would be, I used to have, if I was presenting this workshop for you now 6 years ago, I'd be wearing long sleeves, because my eczema used to be so bad that I would wear bandages on my arms, because if I didn't, my arms were that like cracked that the blood would just like seep through into t-shirts. And I won't elaborate anymore because it sounds gross. But my eczema was that bad that I just wouldn't want to show it. My eczema was that bad that I would make a point of, when I left the house in the morning to go to the office, I would not look in the mirror because I didn't want to see my face, because my face was that red and just raw with eczema that I didn't want to see it. But now that lesson, what actually happened is, after seeing many dermatologists and skin specialists, they told me what the problem was, which was effectively some food intolerances, some things that I shouldn't be eating that I was eating. That actually, in most cases, the things that I didn't actually really need them were pretty much bad foods anyway. And as a result of cutting them out, you always have a skin condition like that, but I was able to get it fully under control, and it's now no longer a problem for me. But not only was it good because I overcame that painful experience of having eczema, which was frankly keeping me from wanting to be in front of audiences and people like that, because I was fearful of being judged for that condition. What it also did is it got me in like the best shape of my life, because as a result of cutting out those foods that weren't actually good for me, it all of a sudden meant that I was like, oh, well, actually, if I can't have those foods and I can only eat these foods, then that means that, well, you know, that's actually good, because I may get I may miss out the instant gratification of eating cheese and nuts and dairy, but actually a lot of those things are not actually beneficial for my body anyway. And then from that point, I didn't just get rid of my eczema, I then ended up getting myself in the best health I've ever got, and I've done like fitness model competitions and cover shoots and all this kind of stuff. And I don't tell you that to show off, I just tell you because what was once a really difficult life lesson turned out to be something that actually has been incredibly profound that I'm really grateful for and I'm proud about. So, in the spirit of this being not about me and being about you, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hand out some cards. And what I would like for you to do, if we can have some music on, like something Hans Zimmery or something would be wonderful. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get you to write down on one side, I'd like for you to write down three things or more that you can think of from the past 90 days that you're really proud about. And when you write down what you're proud about, if things don't immediately spring to mind, I just want you to know this is not all about external things. So this could be, and I actually think that this is even more profound, this could be things that are more about how you developed as a person. So maybe you've had a difficult situation, and the way that you dealt with that difficult situation is very different now to maybe how you would have dealt with it a few years ago. So it doesn't necessarily have to be an external event. It could be that something bad maybe happened or some challenging experience happened, but on reflection you think, wow, the way I dealt with that, I don't know, maybe somebody cut you up in traffic and usually you get all road ragey, but when it happened last week you were just like, I'm just going to be peaceful with that because, you know, it doesn't help the world me being angry back to an angry person. So take just 2 minutes. If you come up with more than five, great. If you come up with five things that you're really proud of, and I said three, but what was five? Things that you're really proud of from the last 9 days. What you've done. So five things in the last 90 days that you're really, really proud of. And once you've done that, those of you that have finished on the back, I would like for you to think about as many as you can think of, but aim for 10 things in your entire lifetime that you're proud of. Think of things you've achieved, new jobs, promotions, meeting your life partner, starting that blog that you've been talking about writing for ages, things to think of. Your whole life, being born, completing school, still being alive. Saving up for that dream holiday that you've always wanted to go on. You wanted to save for it and manage to do it. What are you proud of? Your whole life, what are you really, really proud of? If you find that you get a bit above the mark, kind of push through, because that's your ego doing that game where it's playing and saying you're not good enough. Like, oh yeah, no, that's not a significant achievement, you know, compared to other people. That's nothing. Anything that comes up, you think, you know what, I'm fucking proud of that. Write it down. Okay, and time. Don't worry if you haven't fully done this exercise. My recommendations, as we kind of wrap up, my recommendation is that that's something that you, either with someone here, because you know you're in an environment of people that are like-minded today, this is the kind of environment of people you want to spend more time with and plug into. My recommendation would be that you form maybe an accountability partnership. I have a call with a good friend of mine every day, Monday to Friday, and we talk at 7 a.m. We talk for about 45 minutes, and we start the call by asking what each other is proud of, what we're grateful for, and what some of our magic moments were from the day before. The reason why I think that this exercise is so important is what will feel initially quite mechanical, if you do it over time. I've been writing down what I'm proud of now probably for about, since that call, it's been about 3 years. Every day I've been writing down what I'm proud of. The reason why I feel like this is so important is because if you don't do this, if you don't internally validate yourself, you'll always be reliant on the world and other people telling you that you're good or not good enough. And if you rely on the world and other people to tell you that you're good or not good enough, what's the problem with that? It can go away. So if someone tells you you're amazing and you're great, you know, you hear stories about, give you an example, hear stories about footballers who retire and then turn to negative addictions, alcohol, drugs, gambling, etc. And in most cases, the reason why they do that is because, and the great thing is we're in a room of people where you're all familiar, very familiar with Tony Robbins. Well, the human needs model states that one of our needs is significance. When people post a status on Facebook and people hit like, that's like a little shot of significance in the arm to let you know that what you've said has been validated. And now they've added likes and hearts and angries and all this kind of crazy stuff, and now it's gone a bit out of control. But the point is, that external validation can go away. So it's so important that if that external validation can go away, it's so important that every single day that you validate yourself. Like I said a few minutes ago, it's great to have goals and dreams. It's really good. And I'm sure there'll probably be speakers later that will be talking more about that. It's great to have goals and dreams. Somebody said this morning, they said, you know, I'd just love to just hear one kind of pearl of wisdom, something new, something I've not heard before. Well, I kind of feel like you haven't come here for new, you haven't come here for complicated advice, you haven't come here for a reinvention of the wheel. You already know enough, you're already good enough. You just need to start telling yourself that more often. That doesn't mean don't contribute to the world. Myself and a friend at Christmas, we did an initiative to raise money for the homeless, because I used to be homeless, and we raised tens of thousands of pounds and bought tents and mattresses and food and got Christmas dinner for people. people in Bristol, Birmingham, Manchester, Nottingham, Liverpool, Cardiff, all over the country. It was amazing to see these supplies being spread all over the country. It was marvellous. But I remember a time when I would have probably A, not done that, because I was too busy thinking about myself, or B, I'd have done it purely to get the external praise and validation of it. Now, I am a big believer in doing good things for other people will in many cases bring you external significance. And I always believe if you're doing good things for other people, then you deserve to be validated for that. Like, I love it when people go, oh, that's amazing, that thing you did for the homeless, that's wonderful, well done you, that's great. And I'm sure Ben gets a lot of that through the events that he puts on. Oh, well done, Chevy Destiny, it's amazing, it's fantastic. At the same time, if you do something great and you don't stop at the end of the day and go, oh, you know what, I'm really proud of, insert the thing that you're proud of, then it doesn't matter what you achieve because it'll never be enough. Because you'll always be waiting for someone to tell you, well done, you're brilliant. It's nice to be told, well done, you're brilliant. But there's only one person that really needs to tell you, well done, you're brilliant, every single day, you. Because that can never go away. Every single day you can get up, you can dial zero, which basically means you can call yourself and say, well done, you're brilliant. So it doesn't mean you leave this room and go, right, I'm brilliant, I don't need to do anything else anymore, I am validated, see ya. It doesn't mean that. It does mean go out and do great things and make a contribution. Because with contribution to others, that will bring external validation, significance, praise, well done. But don't do it for the primary reason of getting that. Don't do a great thing for another human being because you want the validation that it was a great thing for another human being. Do the great thing for the other human being because it's good to do good shit for people, right? So don't do it for the validation. Do the validation for yourself at home every single day. I remember a time before I did this where I was deeply depressed and got low self-esteem, and I now know why it was. It was because I didn't feel validated because my dad had left me, and I didn't know why. I felt rejected. And it wasn't until I started doing this process of internally validating myself, telling me that I'm good enough. At first, I'm not going to lie to you, felt a bit mechanical and a bit weird. I can remember the first day of doing it, it was a bit like, oh, should I do that? Oh, I suppose I better do that pride thing, you know. But then now, I fast forward 3 years, and you know, I got this morning and had my call and wrote down what I'm proud of, and it felt really natural. Like, I literally can't, like, my wife knows that, like, I physically, it's so set in me now, I can't start the day without taking the time to write down what are all the things I'm proud of. And I always suggest that when you do it, if you struggle, remember it's not all about external events and accomplishments. Because when you do it, when you focus all on the external with pride, what happens is you maybe start comparing yourself to other people. Oh yeah, but I'm doing this, but they're doing this thing, it's just so big. So no, it's really important that when you do this pride thing, it's not about other people. Speaker Brendan Burchard, Brendan Burchard's got, he asks a great question, which I love, which every time, because just because I do this doesn't mean that I don't ever get like, I don't feel proud today. I still have moments like that. I had a few moments like that this week. It's been a challenging week. And Brendan Burchard asks a great question. He just asks, are you further on in the pursuit of your goals and dreams today than you were 12 months ago? And what I love about that is it goes back to my mum's gym membership days when my mum used to run a gym. And she would always drill into people. She'd always say to men, women, young, old, she'd always say, remember, when you're here at the gym, only focus on yourself. She'd say, don't be looking around at other people. She'd say, I mean this with love. The only person that cares about you being here is the staff. Don't get caught up looking at other people. If there's a person on the cross training next to you that's in better shape than you think you are, don't worry about that. They've worked for that, but don't let that make you feel down. Just focus on yourself. Are you further on in the pursuit of your goals and dreams than you were 12 months ago? The only real comparison that you need to do is with yourself. So if you go, right, on the 7th of April 2018, think about, right, where was I 7th of April 2017? Right. And you may not remember exactly, but if you think about that period of time and think, what have I achieved? And you're writing down what you're proud of from the last 90 days, and you do that every day, it'll make it so much easier for you to be aware of, wow, look how far I've come. Amazing, look at that. So what I want to leave you with is, just remember, you're gonna leave this room and you're gonna have great lives regardless. I know all of you are. The fact that you're here on a Saturday morning when you didn't have to be, no one's forced you to be here, you've been here of your own accord, you're all gonna have great lives. You already do have great lives. All I'm saying for you is be aware of what you've already achieved up until this moment. A great friend of mine recently qualified as a life coach. He said, oh, I don't know how to market myself because I've only just qualified. I'm like, you haven't just qualified. Like, you're 47 years old. You've got 47 years of experience. You haven't just qualified. You're comparing yourself to other coaches who've had a coaching qualification longer than you have. You haven't just qualified. But the problem is what she's doing is she's comparing herself to other people. So you need to make today the day where if it's something that you know that you do, you need to stop doing, and you need to start really consciously validating yourself every single day, writing down what you're proud of every single day, reviewing it every single day. And I guess all I ask is that you, if you ever get into a dialogue with someone who's a bit weird like us and is willing to kind of have this type of edgy dialogue, that you say, I heard this thing at this event once. This guy called Miles, if you ever get an inkling that someone is like unhappy with themselves because they feel like they're inadequate compared to another, you say, I do this process now. It's called pride. And all it is I just write down all the things that I'm proud of about my life to this point. And I do it every single day. Try it. If you want, I'll hold you accountable to doing it for the next 7 days. So all I ask is that you introduce it in your life, play with it for 7 days. It may work for you, it may not. But all I ask is that you try it, and if you really love it, that you pay it forward and you share it with others.
I think it's an amazing idea because it also puts gratitude together, but it also gives the confidence boost.
Yes.
It's a genius idea. I've never heard of it.
And it's funny because I won't even claim that it's like my idea or that it's new. You know, I think that it came for me by that Tony Robbins model, and I looked at the human needs, and I remember actually, at one point in my life, wanting to try and remove significance altogether. I was like, significance is bad. It's like, no, significance isn't bad, but wanting validation and significance from you, like, oh, tell me I'm good, that's like a bad drug to me, because I go, that can go, you can take that away. So if you take that away, I'm like, well, what am I now? And my identity is then linked to what you thought of me, so I now don't know my identity. Whereas if I validate myself, if you validate yourself, you always know you, and you always know that no one's better than you, you're not better than anyone else. It's all about your journey and your process, and you just making sure that you check and tell yourself what you're proud of every single day. That's it. Hope you enjoyed that.
Thank you.